Now, someone, please tell me who Nikita Khrushchev was, and what did he do in relation to the Cuban Missile Crisis?
He was the dictator of Russia.
He was. Yeah, if you want to say it like that.
During the time,
it's probably more appropriate to say he was the leader. He wasn't much of a dictator, but he was the leader. He wasn't like Joseph Stalin or Mussolini, who was the dictator of Italy. Not to that extent, but leader is the appropriate way to say it.
Okay, and did he instigate the missile crisis?
Correct, he did. Correct, that's correct. Just know, classes, that what you need to know is that Nikita Khrushchev led the Soviet Union during the height of the Cold War, serving as the premier from 1958 to 1964. So I'll repeat, he served as leader of the Soviet Union from 1958 to 1964. He became the Soviet Union after Joseph Stalin had died. And Joseph Stalin was the leader of the Soviet Union. Before him, it was, I can't remember his name. I have a brain fart right now. Sorry, we'll get on. That's a topic for another day. Though he largely pursued a policy of peaceful coexistence in the West, he instigated the Cuban Missile Crisis by placing nuclear weapons 90 miles from Florida. Moving on. Does anyone else have, does the class have any questions? All right, moving on. While most Americans remain blissfully unaware of the situation, the CIA formally presented its findings to President Kennedy and his ex-com. Going back to this, ex-com. Ex-com is short for Executive Committee. Make sure you remember that. Made up of several cabinet members and other major advisors, including, like we said, Robert F. Kennedy. Before going on to Robert F. Kennedy, how serious, maybe write this question down, how serious was the threat of Russian missiles in Cuba? Given what you know now, how serious was the threat of the Cuban Missile Crisis? Missiles in Cuba. Write in your own words, stuff, but then tell me. I'll give you a few minutes. I'll repeat. How serious was the threat of Russian missiles in Cuba? But in more detail, even a little bit more, than people are just scared. Of course, people are terrified. This is the closest that we got to World War III. Or would be.
Did people leave the country?
No. There's not really any record of people leaving the country or fleeing stuff. How serious was the threat of Russian missiles in Cuba? Think about it. I mean, these missiles were placed 90 miles off the coast of Florida. These missiles could hit anywhere from New York to Washington, Chicago, Denver, Seattle, Mexico City, Albuquerque, New Mexico, Dallas. I mean, they can hit always within a matter of minutes.
Did everyone, get in power?
People were scared. Well, no, because not even missiles were ever shot. Missiles were never shot. So no one really got recovered. Is that people, just know that people were very afraid, they were very nervous, and it was serious to the point where this was something that shouldn't have been going on. Think about how if you lived during that time, you're just in the middle of the Cold War,